Hi everyone, this is Mistel, and today I'm going to show you how to power level a pet in Warlords of Draenor using the Garrison daily quests. And this time I've gone with the Jahan, Archimedes and Sam, but there's a couple of others that you can utilize as well in case these aren't spawning today. But anyway, I'm going with the Proto Drake Whelpling. I'm going with which is the pet that I want to level, and then I'm going with an Emerald Proto Whelp and another Fairy Dragon, which, as you might know if you've watched my previous videos, I absolutely adore and love. I think it's super awesome in so many fights. But anyway, you can see my Proto Drake Whelp is level 9. You know, it could be lower, it's just that I want to make sure that it can survive two AoEs from Jahan, and they do a kind of like between 200 and 300 damage each. So you should try and have your pet, leveling pet, to be above 500 health at least. Yeah. But that's just a recommendation, of course. So you can see here, I managed to kill off Jahan in one hit, and with one pet. Sometimes you might not manage to do that, that's fine. Just pull in your Nether Fairy Dragon and, you know, do some awesome arcane blasts. Don't use your life exchange until you are absolutely certain that you need it. So you can see here I'm dragging it a little bit because I want to use it on Archimedes instead of on what's it called, Sam. And the first thing that Archimedes does is the wild magic, which means that you have a round where you're not gonna be taking damage, which is good to keep in consideration because you know that you'll be able to survive that round for your life exchange. So there you have it, and look at this. Bam! 4536 XP for that particular fight. That's pretty awesome. So once you do this, make sure that you don't turn in the quest, because then you can actually go back and do it again, which is awesome. So you just continue doing that, well, that's the end of it. You should be able to, if you're really efficient, do this in probably from 5, 6, 7, 9 level to 25. You should be able to do that in, I don't know, 15 minutes max, which is pretty efficient. It's actually better than the grind in Mist of Pandaria. And sometimes, and you might see that now, if you're really, really unlucky with RNG, and you don't time your life exchange yet, right, you might actually have a round where you don't manage to survive. But most of the time, that shouldn't be an issue at all. So, because you can see here, now I'll kill off Sam, even though it looks really dangerous. I'm low on health. Remember that Archimedes is starting out with wild magic, and actually, the lower on health I am here, the better it is for me, because I will take more damage off Archimedes and I will heal up for more. So don't worry too much. You know, the time to worry is if he crits all of his quills, and if he actually gets three in, and that's when you will have to, you know, redo the fight. But it doesn't happen very often. In fact, I think it's happened once or twice for me in the lots and lots and lots of battles that I did in order to test this out. But it might happen. I'm just saying it because someone is going to point it out and be angry that it did happen to them. So yeah, I mean, this is I don't have to do this entire fight. I think I'll actually probably include it in the video anyway without any speech. We'll see. actually, I am just going to show you the last fights because it's going so incredibly fast that I can't actually. Here, of course, it's not going fast because I am forgetting that I had to heal. But have you noticed I'm already at level I'm already at level 20 and I started. Yeah, I don't actually even. I didn't even check the clock, but I don't think it's even been 10 minutes yet, and I'm already at level 20 with the pet. One thing to remember is that I'm doing this with the pet biscuit. What's it called? The magical pet thingy. I should really know this. But yeah, I'm doing this with the pet battle biscuit. I'm getting tired, can you hear? That gives you 50%. That gives you 50% extra XP, and then I also have the safari hat on me, there, which is another 10% XP. So, you know, that's a lot of extra XP to get, and make sure that you do that because it really, really helps when you're trying to do these fast levels. I mean, 60% extra XP is something that you should never, never turn your nose down at. And you can see here, I'm just finishing off Archimedes again. And if you noticed, I was blabbering about something else. But if you noticed, I actually had to use the Nether Fairy Dragon to kill off Jahan. Because my, what's it called? My first pet didn't actually survive all the way through the first kill, and it didn't even matter. I mean, still, I ended up finishing off the fight with no problems. So you can see that even with bad RNG, don't worry immediately. As I said, it might happen from time to time that you have to redo the fight, but most of the time, it really, really isn't an issue. You just have to have, you know, strong nerves, because you can see sometimes you go really, really low before you get your attacks in, but it honestly is fine. And even though you die, you another fairy dragon, which is awesome. Did I mention that I think that another fairy dragon is awesome? It's gonna save the day, I promise, in almost all cases. And you can see I have my moonfire here, but I'm not actually using it because you want to actually build up the arcane blast as much as possible for the last pet here. So there's the gain that you would get from doing moonfire in the beginning, it wanes when you think about how much you can build up the arcane blast. At least I think so. Although in fact it might actually work to have the moonfire, because then you will get some extra damage. Let's try that in this fight. I'll just do that quickly. So you can see now I'm level 23 and I am just gonna do the moonfire this time around. So actually thinking about it and reading the tooltip again, it actually it does make a small bit of a difference, but nothing. I mean, as you can see, I haven't had issues with the fight so far, so nothing that will really make a huge impact on your ability to win this fight. So here again you can see Jan got me down before I got him down, so I am actually just gonna finish him off with a moonfire. And there we go, he's dead. And it changes the weather, so healing will be increased, but I'm not healing here, I'm just swapping. So that's but this one will get another 10% damage, so that might actually be a little bit helpful, we'll see. So here we go, and now I'm faster than Sam and I'm finishing him off, and in come Archimedes and swapping health, bam, doing arcane blast. Oof, that was close, but now I'm faster than him and I'll finish him off. And now I am at level 25, there you go. So how much was that? Was that 8 minutes or something? I think so. I think that's pretty badass. Level 9 to level 25 in 9 minutes or something like that. That is, I'm gonna put the exact number on the video, but that's pretty insane, I think. So I am going to find a couple of other garrison fights that you can power level on, and I'll put that up on videos as well at some point. But for now, you can, you know, whenever you have this combination, then make sure you use it. And also, I can't actually remember at this point if I mentioned it, but if you don't have the Emerald Protowelp, Chrominus is really good as well, and the Emerald Whelpling is really good, but I didn't want to use either because they're not as easy to get as the actual Emerald Protowelp. So that's about it. I hope you liked this video. If you did, make sure you subscribe, because there's a lot more coming up all the time. And of course, as always, make sure you leave comments in the comment section below. I love getting feedback, so I really appreciate it when you do that. Until next time, bye bye.